yeah, here in the wild wilderness of Northeast Philadelphia, I'll be hunting some simple machines.
Hopefully we get lucky enough to spot a wild Yerkes. Wild Yerkes, 5'8", male, blonde hair. Not 100% sure if he's human or not.
Yeah, he's very vicious. He's usually on like all fours. So
damn, I spotted him!
He got away.
He left behind some simple machines from his droppings.
Looks like he left behind this wedge. A wedge is an inclined plane with one or two sloping sides. This has one. You could, the force going down, my hands and arms are the input force, and the output force is the shovel going into the ground.
Looks like he also left behind a first class lever. Fulcrum being in the middle, my hand being the effort force, and the air being the resistance force on the other end.
We're also out here in the dangerous wilderness, hunting for the wild Yerkes. It's dangerous knowing that this thing can jump out on you anytime, anywhere.
If she ever does jump out, I have this third class lever here with my hands being the fulcrum, the pole itself being the effort force, and Yerkes being the resistance force, like this.
Wild Yerkes! Wild Yerkes! Back here! In pursuit of the Wild Yerkes, the Yerkes ran up this wooden plank, hopping over this log. The wooden plank is an example of an inclined plane. The wooden plank increases the distance, but reduces the amount of effort of the Wild Yerkes when traveling up it.
Oh, he left behind this bag. It's a clock. This is an example of a wheel and axle, with the wheel being the centerpiece, and these hands are the axles moving around the wheel. The wheel is the effort force, while these hands are the resistance force moving around the wheel.
Got him in my sight.
Hoppins, did you get our dinner for the night? When I open the door, it acts as a second class lever. My hand's the effort force, the air is the resistance, and the hinges are the fulcrum.
Yeah, I said we cooked that sucker up.
He's awake!
He's risen!
What's in his hand?
This is a water bottle. The top is an example of a screw. The screw is the inclined plane wrapped around the cylindrical post. The inclined plane helps to put the top back on the bottle.
I'm gonna call Kevin's phone and it's gonna vibrate, which is gonna act as an inclined plane and hit the car, which is a wheel and axle, and the car will hit the marble, which will act as a second class lever.
The marble rolls down the roller, which acts as an inclined plane.
The dominoes hit the marble, which acts as a third class lever rolling down the chopsticks, which are an inclined plane.
So after the dominoes, the marble acts as a third class lever when hitting the car.
The car, acting as a wheel and axle, hits the red cup, putting the cereal into the bowl.
The marble acts as a third class lever and hits the dominoes, and then the dominoes hit each other, acting as second-class levers.